we get into the review, I do want to give a huge shout out to Mattel for making this review possible by sending us this entire wave of Ghostbusters WWE Elite figures available at Walmart very soon and exclusive to Walmart. Thank you so very much, Mattel. Now let's get into this review. What is good, everybody? Welcome to an epic My Damn Toys video. Today we have an epic WWE Elite Series review on the brand new Walmart exclusive WWE Ghostbusters Elite set, guys. Yes, we have the brand new Ghostbusters Elite set. We're going to be going through the entire series and reviewing all of them. I am super excited to have this set in my hands. You know, when they first showed the promo pics, wasn't too excited, but seeing them here in person, they look really, really good, and I'm very excited for them, guys. We have The Rock. We have John Cena, we have Shawn Michaels, we have The Undertaker, and Stone Cold Steve Austin. Five of the greatest in-ring competitors in wrestling history, not just WWE. But I think the coolest thing about these things, guys, is the packaging. I mean, look at these things. Look at them. They look absolutely immaculate. Just check this out. You got the green slime going down. You have Ghostbusters across the top. You have your front viewing window here, Elite Collection. I think they did a fantastic job on these. You have little silhouettes of the wrestlers on the back. You have this really wicked shot of Undertaker on the back as the ghost, and you have your Ghostbusters here, and then on the back it says, when there's something strange in your neighborhood, who you gonna call? Of course, playing on the old Ghostbusters theme song, and I'm sure that people will sing it at the beginning of videos and it'll be really stupid. But here it says, the ectoplasmic Undertaker rises from the grave to claim the WWE Championship for the land of the dead. So John Cena, Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Rock, and Shawn Michaels strap their proton packs to their backs to bring the title back to the WWE Universe. So it's sort of just this little play on, you know, whatever. And I think it's kind of dumb how they just crossed it over. They take two, you know, really niche markets, put them together, and you get this Elite Series. But I want to give a huge shout out to Mattel for sending us this series, guys. It's really epic of Mattel. Thank you so much to Mattel and everybody over there for sending us this epic wave. And it looks incredible. I cannot wait to crack them all out of their packaging. We thank Mattel so much for sending us this. They are Walmart exclusive. They should be hitting shelves very, very soon, and we appreciate Mattel so very much for sending us these epic figures, and we're going to find out if the set is worth it. We're going to crack all of them out of their packaging, take a closer look at every single figure, and I forgot to mention they also have the Ghostbusters logo at the top right here, and I love the little sheen they got going on. So with that being said, guys, let's go ahead and Ghostbust these hoes out of their freaking packaging. So here are the Ghostbusters and Ghost Undertaker out of their packaging, guys. Stone Cold, The Rock, Undertaker, Shawn Michaels, and my man John Cena. Three of my favorite wrestlers of all time right here between Stone Cold, The Rock, and John Cena. And of course, we have Taker and Shawn Michaels as well. I mean, these are five fantastic in-rings, just five of the GOATs of all time in professional wrestling. Now, when this wave was first shown, guys, I thought this was very dumb. I'm going to be honest with you. I was just like, you know, how does it fit? You know, where do these cross over? I mean, I can see where the Undertaker crossovers. You know, he's got sort of a ghostly sort of gimmick. You know, he's got a darker side, which makes sense with ghosts and ghouls and demons of that nature. But with the rest just being Ghostbusters and just stuff, I don't know. I've never been a big Ghostbusters guy. While I do love Bill Murray, I've always been a big fan of Bill Murray, one of my favorite actors of all time. I've just never been into Ghostbusters. I've given them a watch a few times, and I've just never been hardcore into it. Don't get me wrong, you know, I respect it and everything. It just hasn't been for me. However, when you look at these figures, I actually really am feeling them. You know, I haven't taken them out of their gear yet, and we will take a closer look at what they look like under the gear, but right now, you know, I can't say that I'm totally in love with the idea. However, we're going to break it into it and get into it and see if they're actually worth it or not. But they come with a slew of accessories. I mean, my God, all of them have a slew of accessories. Undertaker's probably the only one that doesn't, but he's badassery. I mean, look at, he's translucent purple, for Christ's sake. But we're going to get into it, guys. Let's just go ahead, break down each figure, what they come with, and take them out of their accessories. I guess we could start from right to left, and we'll take a closer look at Undertaker dead last, because he's translucent purple, for Christ's sake. So taking a closer look at my favorite wrestler of all time, guys, we have John Cena here, and I really like this head sculpt. You know, it's kind of a take on the brand new head sculpt that we will be getting in Elite Series 72, I think, or is it 71? I can't freaking remember, but it looks like he's kind of younger. Is that crazy? But it kind of looks like he's a little bit younger here. He does come with a t-shirt, his dog tags, a belt, and a proton pack, and it's the little backpack that they suck the ghosts up into. Again, I don't know everything about it, but I do know that these are the little backpacks. They go on their back, and they ghost bust with them. You know, they try to suck up the ghosts into the backpack. pack. Think Luigi's Mansion and things of that nature. But he has the lime green bands going on right here that have his logo, the HLR logo here. And on this side, it does have the Ghostbusters logo on his actual wrist there. So it's pretty cool that Mattel got with Ghostbusters. And I guess Ghostbusters, I'm guessing Mattel made their figures for Ghostbusters and the movies and things of that nature. So they were able to, you know, get together here, crossover with WWE, and now you have this set. So what I do really like about the figure is that you can take off this belt. So you have a little utility belt here, and it is cool. One thing, again, that I do love, I love the gray shorts. It's like a gray khaki, and you can make different fix-ups with these shorts. You know, you could pop these arms off and do any John Cena attire with any of his elites, and you could get a really cool attire out of it. Same thing with the shoes. I do like the gray, black, and white shoes. Again, you could do some different fix-ups and things of that nature, which I think I'm going to do. I do want to keep a set, you know, like they are. I really like the Ghostbusters look just because, you know, I would like a set how they are. However, I think you could do some different things with it, which I will be attempting with this John Cena. I think I'm going to do the same thing with the Shawn Michaels about vomited right there. But that is something that you can definitely do. We can pop this shirt off real quick so you guys can see what John Cena looks like underneath. And underneath, he does have his bicep band as well. And he looks good, man. It's sort of the Elite 34 armband and, you know, the lime green attire that he had with the camo shorts. But I really like this head scan. Again, I really am digging the head scan, and I think it's really sweet. Comes with dog tags and all that stuff. But I do want to get a zoom-in shot of this Proton pack right here. You guys can see all kinds of detail. I mean, the sculpt on this thing is fantastic. Look at all the sculpting and the wiring and the colors and everything. It looks just like it does that I can remember from the movie. If anybody is a Ghostbusters enthusiast out there, let me know if this is accurate. It looks pretty accurate to me. I mean, it's got the straps and everything. It has the little gun here. You got the magnet going on. I think that's a magnet. I could be a jackass, but it looks pretty good. I think it looks nice. And again, I'm not a Ghostbusters enthusiast, so this could be completely wrong, but it looks good to me. All the sculpt work here and everything looks nice, but that is pretty much it. But that's pretty much it for John Cena, guys. So let's move on to Stone Cold Steve Austin. So with Stone Cold Steve Austin, guys, you can see he looks completely different than John Cena. While he does come with his own cloth accessories, which is a big bonus with these guys, three out of the five figures do come with cloth accessories here, but I really do like this jumpsuit. It says Austin there, has the Ghostbusters logo here, and really cool, sweet stuff. I mean, it's way better than that one we got with Daniel Bryan. It's not thin. It's actually thick. It's got some good stuff compared to the Bray Wyatt, you know, family Elite 32 Daniel Bryan. So that's just something to take note of. He also comes with a Proton pack. I believe all four of the superstars besides Undertaker come with a Proton pack because they are the Ghostbusters of the WWE Universe. He also comes with an Austin vest here, and I believe we have seen this before. It says Austin. It has the skull. 316. On the back, you have Stone Cold with the three skulls. I do believe we've gotten this vest before. I could be wrong about that, but for the most part, I'm pretty sure we have gotten it. I'm going to take off the belt on the back again. You can just unsnap this. Very easy. It's sort of like a championship belt. Again, lots of great details going on with this. It looks really good. I like that they included that. A lot of these figures have a ton of accessories, but we're going to slide this off of Austin just to see what he looks like underneath, because I know that you guys are wondering what he looks like, and I am also wondering, even though we saw the promo pictures, we got to know, you know, here today, what the hell this man looks like underneath the freaking jumpsuit. So sliding this off right here and pulling this off here. Okay, so it's very interesting. They have the knee pads over the jumpsuit, which I think is very interesting as well. But underneath the jumpsuit, guys, you will see, I'm not going to take it all the way off, but it's pretty cool. It's a take on his Bloody Austin 316 shirt. I'm pretty sure you guys know what I'm talking about. I think it's the shirt he wore after his WrestleMania match with Bret Hart. It may have even been before that, but this usually is red, and this time they have it in green because it's supposed to be like the slime or whatever dripping on the back. There's nothing, and they do have the black shoulders with no sleeves painted on. He's got black wrist tape, and he has the black trunks going on instead of the regular shorts. Or jorts, I should say. So not only did they not include jorts with John Cena here, they gave him the gray here, they gave Stone Cold his wrestling trunks, so that's just something to take note of. And he does have the short boots like we've seen, and he has his knee pads over the jumpsuit, but he does not have knee braces, and you can't see his belly button. So they just painted up a Stone Cold torso. But now that we've covered Stone Cold, guys, let's get into The Rock. So next up, guys, we are taking a closer look at The Rock. Again, he does come with the Proton pack, and I think this is pretty much a re-release of the Elite 47.5 Rock or Elite 47. I think it's the Elite 47.5. But he comes with the belt again. He has elbow pads this time. He has the same head sculpt that we did see with that Elite 47.5. I don't think it's True Effects technology. If it is, then it's very slightly different. He does have a little nose chip right there. I don't like that nose chip. Gonna have to get that black paint off there. But removing the jumpsuit, I think this is pretty much a painted torso onto an Elite 47.5 Rock, and that is what it's looking like to me, just like Stone Cold back here. But it looks like they actually left his sleeves off of his little jumpsuit here, and it looks like they did the same thing. So right here on the front, it says Team Bring It in green instead of white, which is pretty cool. And on the front of the trunks, it says The Rock, but there's no logo on the butt cheeks, man. And again, he does have, oh, okay, this is weird. I just now noticed this. Look at their knee pads. I just noticed the knee pads are not regular knee pads, guys. They strap together like the belt, and they're a little bit bigger. So not only did they give them, they gave them larger knee pads, but they have like these little buckles on the back, so you can take them off like that instead of having to slide them off. So that's pretty cool. I just now noticed that, but The Rock is not much different from the Elite 47.5 Rock. Again, it's just a painted torso. You can see his belly button here. He's got his same head sculpt and everything. It's literally, they stuck an Elite 47.5 Rock, painted the torso, added some accessories, and that is what you get. He has the same Rock boots that we've seen in the past many, many times. So now that we've covered The Rock, guys, let's get into Shawn Michaels. So for Shawn Michaels, guys, this one's pretty interesting. Not only does he come with a proton pack, but he also comes with this little digamahoo. And I can't tell you what the hell this is, but it's got a lot of great detail. Again, I don't know what this is. Again, I'm not big on Ghostbusters, but it comes with this little effect piece that's translucent green, and you can unplug this from this little doohickey. And I don't know what this doohickey is. Somebody can comment down below if they know what it is, but it's this little, I don't know what the hell to even call it, guys. It's very interesting. So what you have is this right here. It's attached to this string, and it's attached to this little device, and these little doors are actually hinged, and they can open and close. So you can have this open or closed, which has a lot of great detail. You can see the hinges here can open and close. And what you do is you port this little green effect piece into the hole, and there you go. Now you can capture Undertaker, and you can suck him up into the thing. And again, I don't know what the hell this is, but you can suck up the Undertaker. Suck up the Undertaker. Suck up the Undertaker. Suck up the Undertaker. But that is it for Shawn Michaels, guys. One thing I will say is that, or that's it for his accessories. One thing I will say is I thought that John Cena was going to come with the hat, but apparently it's Shawn Michaels. So you do get this little Ghostbusters hat, and on the front it is black, and it says, or it doesn't say anything, but it has the Ghostbusters logo. So it's just your regular black hat with the Ghostbusters logo. I'll probably add this to my John Cena because I think it would fit better. You know, Shawn Michaels, the reason he comes with it is because of that DX figure that we got, and that's the reason, and I can understand that, but I think it looks better on the John Cena. And we do get this sleeveless shirt that says Michaels instead of a jumpsuit. He gets the, just, you know, that same shirt that we've seen multiple times with Shawn Michaels. Nothing on the back, no Ghostbusters logo, no DX or nothing, but he does have DX on his wristbands, which is pretty cool. They have the old arm articulation, I think. They have the interchangeable hands, I think. Yes, they have the interchangeable hands, guys, so that is something to note as well. They do have the interchangeable hands. Even though none of them come with interchangeable hands, you can interchange their hands, so that's pretty cool there. Again, same belt that we get with all the other figures, and this is probably my favorite one from the set as far as attire goes, besides John Cena. I think I would rank this number one, though. Is the first time that I saw these figures, guys, I knew that I wanted to take this Shawn Michaels, and I wanted to get some extra of these legs, and I wanted to paint up these pants like some of his other attires that have that off-white slash gray color, and I think that's what I'm going to do here. So that is something you can do. He doesn't have his heart logos on the little sides of the waist. However, I don't think that would be a big deal. He's not on ball joints, so that's something also to take note of, but really awesome looking attire. I'm a big fan of this Shawn Michaels. We've seen this head sculpt probably 650 times. I think it would have been cool to get the defining moments, or that, whatever this head sculpt would be, the older with the longer hair and pullback in the ponytail, but you know, it is what it is. But nonetheless, great looking Shawn Michaels, and we're probably going to do some customization with this as well as the John Cena. But now that we've covered Shawn Michaels, guys, let's get into the final figure in the set, which is going to to be The Undertaker. So getting into The Undertaker dead last, guys, he does come with a championship, and this is a custom championship, and it's basically the old WWE championship, except it is on a translucent green strap, and the plates have no details really in them. They're just solid gold, and I don't think this glows in the dark. I'm going to cut the lights off real quick and just see if it glows in the dark. I don't think it does, but yeah, I don't think it glows in the dark. However, it's pretty cool anyways. Really sweet stuff going on with this translucent green WWE championship. I don't know why I thought it glued in the dark. I guess I just took a shot on it. Maybe that would have been a cool feature nonetheless. But this Undertaker's badassery, guys. I really do enjoy this. So not only do you get the championship, guys, but you do get the translucent purple hat, which does have some bends and waves in it, which sucks eggs, but maybe I can get that ironed out. I'm not sure how I'll do that. Probably just stick it on him and leave it forever. But this Undertaker figure is so badass, guys. I want you guys to understand just how sweet this thing is. Look at this head sculpt right here. It's all translucent purple. You have white eyes on this Undertaker. It's probably the best Undertaker head sculpt as far as that is concerned, because we've seen this before. It is that WrestleMania 35 head scan, except it's completely purple, translucent plastic, and then they have the eyes whited out. He even has his beard, and he even has his tattoos over his skin tone here, and I don't know if you guys can see, but they are there, and it's just, golly, dude, that's so sick how it's translucent purple. I just love this. I don't know how you would really use this. Maybe you could do like a translucent purple entrance or something for like a Mania or like a pay-per-view for your pick feds or something, but this is badass. Or it's got the singlet look instead of the pants look, which I really like. You know, it's a different take on it. Just going all the way down, and it's completely translucent purple. The skin tone's a little bit pinkish, but I still think it works. It works really, really well going down into the boots, and I kind of feel like his feet have like a fade in them. Like his the front of his boots are like a lighter purple slash pink, and then the rest of them is in a darker purple, except for when you get to the skin tone. But I don't know if you guys can see the tattoos, but they are there. You can see the tattoos slightly coming through there, and just what a fantastic figure. Definitely one of the best figures in the set. He's got the choke slamming hands. He also has the wristbands or the wrist cuffs for his gloves, and that is pretty much it for the figures, man. I mean, you have The Undertaker, you got Shawn Michaels, The Rock, John Cena, Stone Cold, and Shawn Michaels, if I didn't say him already. But now that we've taken a closer look at the dead man, guys, let's line up all these figures and see what they look like all together. So here are all the WWE Ghostbusters Elite figures, guys. Stone Cold, The Rock, Undertaker, Shawn Michaels, and John Cena all in their glory. You can see here I added the hat to my John Cena, and I really like the way that came out. I think that looks much better than on the Shawn Michaels. It just ties together even better. But again, guys, a huge shout out to Mattel for making this review possible and sending us this full Ghostbusters Elite WWE figure set, available at Walmart very, very soon. They are Walmart exclusive, so you can only get them at Walmart and probably online somewhere, but they're probably going to charge an arm and a leg. So you definitely want to find these at retail, guys, and they should be hitting stores very, very soon. So again, huge thank you to Mattel for making this review possible. But that is going to do it for this 5-in-1 full Elite Series review on the Ghostbusters Walmart exclusive WWE Elite set. Guys, thank you so very much for watching. I would love to know your thoughts on all the figures down below. Overall, I really like the set. I think The Undertaker is very sweet. I think you can do some epic customs with them. And if you're a huge Ghostbusters slash WWE fan, these are definitely the figures for you, and you should definitely grab all of them. Or if you're a big fan of one of these guys in particular, I would definitely grab them. But I would say the one that you would most definitely need to grab is Undertaker. I think that he is epic. I think this is really cool that Mattel did with him, and I really like Shawn and John Cena for future customs, and maybe you could paint The Rock or Austin's shirt. But that is going to do it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Comment down below your whole thoughts on this set. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you.